Hello, it's me, Detective. I guess we're policing the hypnospace. Was that the seepage song that it was playing? I think that was the seepage song. Alright. Look at our desktop. Beautiful. Look at our dead pet. Yeah, I don't even know what we're doing in this right now. I think our mission was a mass cleanup. So, the game essentially in the first chapter was giving us like options of things to pursue. I have it written down. Content infringement, harassment, illegal activity, malicious software, and extra legal commerce. I don't think we reported anything for extra legal commerce. And I think even the malicious software, we only really reported in the final mission. Like, there was only one malicious software. Really? I think so, right? Because we didn't do the Dr. Helper, Mr. Helper thing for malicious software. I think we banned that for extra legal commerce or maybe illegal activity. I think it was illegal activity because it was Kappa Cash instead of using the, like, Hypno Coin. The same with like all the other stuff, right? The True Tranquility. I think the True Tranquility also went down for something similar. Anyway, oh God. Give me a minute. All right, we're good to go. So yeah, today, I guess that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna just like do what it says. Go into all the verses that we're allowed to go into and start hitting up these people for breaking the rules. Has there been an update to the Hypnospace page? Oh! Coalfest helicopter crash. Coalfest 99 helicopter crash. An icy end to a rocky evening by Derek McGallum.
Mere seconds after rocking Coolfest 99 with his classic refrain of I am the
No!
Chowderman, Eric Chowderman, Hellman and his Cruncher bandmates would attempt to end their performance in style by lifting off in his personal
It didn't kill
helicopter.
them!
They were not successful, and the Chowdercopter went down in a field adjacent to the concert venue after becoming ensnared in decorative scaffolding. Cruncher drummer Cuff Johnson died in the crash. Seven other occupants, including three fans who won a sweepstakes contest, were seriously injured. Chowderman himself suffered the loss of his right leg. Coolfest attendees were already on edge after a minor riot during FRE3's set after he was allegedly caught lip-cinching.
Lip cinching instead of sinking. Chowderman lost his leg? What the actual fuck? Oh my god. What about sports? What's going on with the Trennis? 8-0 on the Trennis? Dude, I am absolutely shocked. King Foods shares surge after new Bopo's merger. King Foods shares surge after new Bopo's merger. This is the
This is
new
a new
era.
era of cooperation and unrivaled consumer value, and I, for once, couldn't be happier to see it, said King Foods CEO Jack Kent upon announcing a buyout of longtime market share Bopo's Fine Meats.
So
Bopo's
there's
has
not going to be
always
any
been a
Bopo's
family
Fine
company,
Meats
says Bopo's
now?
CEO Tyler Bopo, so
Or are
it's a
they
pleasure
keeping
to
the
enter the
name?
quite large King Foods family. You could say I'm surrounded by family now. So much family. Analysts speculate that stock prices for both companies may rise by as much as HypnoCoin 5 during the complex integration process. However, King Foods CEO Richard Epson promises that the people who stand to benefit most are consumers. Whether it's in their home kitchens, or our state-of-the-art yet affordable lunch counter restaurants, our customers are the real winners here, Epson said. Tyler Bopo was kindly escorted from the building.
Oh, what the fuck? I feel like this was a shady deal. Alright, that's your business news. Let's go politics. Presidential hopeful, dream of sleep time success.
With the 2000 presidential election approaching, hopefuls across the political spectrum are turning their eyes towards hypnospace as the next political battleground. Republican frontrunner Daniel Wilkinson's slogan, strong, firm, American is set to appear prominently across the sleep time social network come December, as is that of Democrat underdog Patricia Herning, America, great today, better tomorrow. Third-party candidates have also embraced this new virtual fronter, with Traffic Party representative Jackson Jackson and independent candidate Roger Ellis committing to personally build their own presences in sleep time sometime next year.
Cool. I just opened a window. Sorry if it was loud as fuck. Tragedy in the Middle East.
204 confirmed dead after coalition forces bombed a medical facility believed to house terrorist operatives. The coalition has repeatedly denied accusations by human rights groups that its actions amount to war crimes, citing comprehensive intelligence and reconnaissance before each mission.
I mean, bombing a hospital is literally a war crime, right? Like, there's no two ways about them. However, so is, like, bombing schools and stuff like that. And I believe lately... Wait a minute, somebody has the username... Despresso on Twitch, DESPPRESSO. So spelled exactly the same as my name, apart from after the first E, there's an extra S. And they're on 76 viewers playing fucking Valorant, and they're partnered. What the fuck? Is somebody stealing my identity? Oh, it's a girl. Okay. Never mind. Back to the game. As soon as I find out they're a girl, I'm like, I don't want any of that fucking heat. I don't even want to say their name ever again. That's it.
Welcome to Hypnospace Patrol Department Enforcer Training.
Alright, more websites. That was the news. Let's have a look at the old cafe. This guy's page looks the same. Barnaby's chair looks the same. Oh, this is a new song. Our heartfelt condolences to Cuff Johnson and those impacted by the incident at Coalfest. This is actually spooky. Yeah, I'm getting out of there. This is a spooky site. Chit chat. Have a quick look, see if they're doing anything. Nope. Don't bother. Updated weekly for your displeasure. Told you. Who owns this? 00706A. Not one of the ones I wrote down, is it? No. God damn. Alright. I think why I enjoy this game so much is I actually do like reporting accounts. I like reporting accounts when it's a real violation on like Instagram and stuff like that. On Instagram daily, I'll get like one message request. A new message requests go into like the separate inbox and it doesn't cause a notification. You've got to like purposefully seek it out. And if I let it build up, I get a bunch of them. And what you can click on is you can click delete message and it says, do you also want to block the person? You say yes. And then it says, do you also want to report the person? And you can say yes. And then you report them for, you know, whatever violation they've done. And normally I just report them for spam, but sometimes I report them for scam as well. If it's something like a cash redoubling scheme or like a crypto scheme. Yeah. It's a thing. House of Sound under construction. We are changing to digital format. Oh, this is the guy that used to scan his posters, right? He used to scan his like old school zines. And then now he's actually turned them into text. A round of applause for Casper Air Graphics, Gearhead Greg, and Alan for Obi for all their help in making my page nicer. Yeah, this guy's a wholesome guy. This looks so much better than his last page. He's even scanned these, like, properly. Look. They have...
The legitimacy of
yeah,
praise as a genre.
Yeah, he even has you able to, like, text the speech chip. Cool. I don't think he's doing anything bad anyway. Ah, this is still... This is, like, his old style, where you've got to actually read it. We've read that already. Thank you to Gearhead Greg for helping me learn this page builder. It's so hard. Alan for Obi for helping me out with the graphics for New House of Sound Online. We're working on a fully digitized version to put up soon. Cool. Alright. Hypno Tech Tips by Gearhead Greg. I think this is the one where he gives advice on how to make a good password, right? Was that the thing that I was looking for? Hi everyone, don't share the teen-up hoax. My niece is in high school and has never heard of such a thing. I tried notifying the counselor, Ronnie. Just a hoax, but no reply. Just FYI. The teen-ups aren't even real. Nobody's shonking teen-ups. Oh my god. This is it. This is the thing. Picking a secure password. Alright. How the world do I pick a secure password? One question I always get. This is my personal favorite method. A great example might be the city you live in, your favorite hobby, and your birth year. So if you live in Denver, you're 29, and your hobby is computers, wow, mine too, your password would be Denver Computers 1970. I think this is the thing to get into the sharing music section of the game. But, so it's the city, it's the hobby, and then it's the birth year. I wonder if you can get other people's passwords then, if it's not just the one guy's. So his is Denver Computers 1970, right? Music. And there's so much music. I forgot what the thing is. Is it WITW? No, that's What in the World, right? Oh no, I should have wrote it down on a sticky note. Share. What was the music sharing thing called? DigExchange, this is it. FLST. I'm gonna write it down on a sticky note. Where's my sticky notes? God, I can't even... There we go. Cool. Put it over there. So his is Denver Computers 1970. Yeah, which is not gonna be. It's not gonna be. But... If we type in Merchant Soft and we head over to the main Merchant Soft page and then go to Adrian's page. It's Dylan's page, Dylan's page. I want the page that has Meet the Team. Okay. Dylan Merchant, blah blah blah. So we'd be looking for Dylan's password, right? If Dylan did Gearhead Greg's method. Dylan, create hypnospace. Music, art, code, So it could maybe be music or art is the hobby. Okay. And if he's 21 years old, that would mean he was born in 1978. It doesn't tell you where he's born though, right? Programming. Oh god, he's got so many hobbies. I don't think he was born in San Francisco, but I have to try it, right? +21 = 1999, right? Shit. I guess we'll keep that on the back burner as something we need to keep looking for. Hold on. Gearhead Greg is 49 years old, and he says his password is, Wait, hold on. He says his password would be 1970, which would make him 29. Oh no. Ah, it would make you 29 if you were born in that year. But he was born in 1950. So his would be Lexington. Okay. And then 1950. And his hobby would be computers, right? Is it as easy as this? Lexington computers, 1950. You are fucking kidding me. You are fucking kidding me. It was as simple as that. I was going to be looking at everybody else's shit. Welcome to FLIST. Enjoy your stay. Rules. First page must be hidden. No zone listing. If we see pages listed here, we will delete. No linking ID sharing without permission. Special thanks, DM and Gearhead Greg. Yeah, this is Dylan Merchant and Gearhead Greg, right? Welcome to press... Oh my god, it's me. How to find FLIST file directories. You are now able to see FList directories by searching for FList IDs. FList IDs are formatted as follows. F plus the last six characters of a headband ID. Do not share FList directories other than your own without permission. Keep FList music and software related, no porn. Be aware that merchant self-developers and enforcers can see your headband ID for your citizen data. So there's a chance they can find your FList if they gain access. Oh... Okay, how do I put this in though? Where does this go? Where do I type this in? Like where do I put in the F plus the head data shit? I'm not understanding this. Unless what it means is, like, I search for F and then, like, the code, right? Huh. I need a sheet of paper for this shit. It's the last six letters. God, it's so hot tonight again. It's like a tropical fucking heat. And I'm not, like, you know, memeing. It's so humid right now because it was a big storm yesterday. We had thunder and lightning yesterday. For 6 hours straight, then like a 2 hour break, and then another 6 hours straight with rain throughout the whole time. I think we had more rainfall last night than we're meant to have in 6 weeks. We got 6 weeks worth of rain in about 12 hours because we've had a big drought lately and it hasn't rained because of the heat wave, and then it all like came at once. And it's still wet outside, but it's not like raining, you know? But we're due for more thunder and lightning tonight. We actually had a power cut last night because of the thunder and lightning. Why am I even talking about this? Let's just play the game, alright? Uh-oh. Alright, we're not going there yet. We're going here. Jay's software reviews. Well, I know I said I was taking a break, but I can't stay away from this place. Still really tired, but it's worth it to be with you all. Really tired? Why would you be really tired if you do this when you're asleep? You know what I'm saying? So his ID is 02502A. And that's Jas Wilson Lopez. Alright, Jas. Cool. This guy's a software review guy, so the chances of him having, like, pirate music on his account is pretty high, right? Pretty high. Dragon, adopted from Phaedrella. I'm naming mine Kenny. He likes corn, dogs, and burnt. Who the hell is this? Marjorie Paulson. I have moved all of my pages to the Sovereign Alliance of Imagination Freelance. Come see me there. What the hell? My potions. Adopt a dragon? Likes eating people, stealing, grinning.
Downloading Dragon Drathian.
Oh, dude, we're downloading all of these. Loves eating big mushrooms and shapeshifting.
Downloading Dragon Snogaliath. Downloading Dragon Gradalus.
This is great. Playing in snow, staying in her cave, freezing people at high altitudes. So this all just goes to the same page. Alright. Welcome to Phaedrella's Apothecary. This is where you can find my potions, elixirs, and magical formulas, or anything that ails you. Do enjoy my wares. Goobery Delight. Goobery Delight is Phaedrella's famous family recipe passed down from her witch grandmom. Effects: extra magic mana, energy, makes you smell good. Water, C plus magic. Oh, no, it's not C plus, it's brackets. Water is the most famous drink for good reason. It's good for you and it's in all the rivers. Effects: health, energy, detox of your body, animals like you more and lick you. You know, the first couple are kinda true. Green dragon milk, pumped from the breast of a nursing green dragon mother, always- Oh, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, this is like fucking the blue milk in Star Wars. Effect: makes strong babies if you're pregnant. Vitamins and minerals like spinach. Jesus. Pumped from the breast of a nursing fairy. What's up with all the breast pumping? What the fuck is this? Totally ethical, Phaedrella always pays a handsome sum. Effects: makes you fly, jump high, better singing, and sparkling skin. Vampire blood, sometimes called vampire milk, because this special liquid is pumped from the nursing vampires. Don't worry, it's not that's horrifying. Imagine, like, somebody- Oh, their breast, like, leaking milk from the nip- Oh, God. Turns you into a vampire for 3 days. Just like a free- like a trial. Like a little trial. Goobery Delight, big size. Phaedrella's grandma's famous elixir. Extra mana, makes you smell good, okay. Stone beer. It looks like this one hasn't been unlocked. Like, compared to all the other colors. Tastes like rocks, but it makes you strong like rocks too. Big muscles, don't drink too much, your muscles will grow and grow until they explode. Holy, this is like, it reads like a DeviantArt fetish page. Also, she looks very strange. Very strange. The, about a quarter of her head is here, and then another, like, half is her nose and eyes, and then another, oh god. She seems nice. She seems nice. Let's look for freelance. Nothing. Huh. Because this is in Starport Castle. Starport Castle Dream Station. Do we have access to Starport Castle Dream Station from here? We don't. They've never given us this. 2, 4, 6. There are 6 things here. I guess we have a read of this.
A new zone for all you geeks, nerds, and other citizens with niche interests. Welcome to Starport Castle Dream Station, a new zone where fans of fantasy, science fiction, and other niche interests may converge. If your listed pages appeared in one of the following zones, they have now been relocated here. SCIFI Starport, Gamert Only, The Comic Shop, The Dream Castle, CyberCop Station.
Okay. The Bullring, unofficial Taurus fan resource. The Bullring has moved to SEI Freelance. While I still love the Merchant Brothers and believe in Merchantsoft as a company, I feel it's only right to stand with my friends in these trying times. The Bullring does not claim ownership of Taurus or this related character. This is a non-commercial fan page. Sad that it's come to this. I support my employers, but I also support my friends, so I have joined the Freelance. His ID is very low. This is actually the guy that works for Merchantsoft, right? That loved that Taurus comic. I like how Taurus, the bull, is wearing, like, chucks. Like, he's wearing a pair of Chuck Taylor, like, highs. Let's take this guy's ID. This is Roddy. And his ID is 00021D. Cool. I'm also gonna hit this guy up for copyright infringement. No violation. Hold up. Come on. Okay. So I guess we need to try and gain access to the Freelance, right? Oh, this is Linda's weird stuff. We've seen this bloody hand thing. Linda's Library of Weird is now located in this SIAI Freelance. Ah. Sovereign Alliance of Imagination. Because Merchantsoft has been seen fit to merge our zones with no warning or several and severely limit our download speeds, the remaining members of the 5 deleted zones have come together to form Sovereign Alliance of Imagination. We have decided in unison to delist our pages and form our own zone, free from the control of Merchantsoft. Click here to explore the Freelance. So what they've done is made an unlisted page that lists to the other pages, similar to how we have a landing page for all the official zones.
In October of 1999, Merchantsoft destroyed 5 of Hypnospace's strongest communities by condensing them all into one zone. Our pages now load half as quickly as well. No one knows why it happened, it just did. Now, instead of having 5 community leaders for each zone, we just have one, and the person they picked is just a friend of Merchantsoft. If you don't have a community leader, there's no way to report issues directly to Merchantsoft outside of waking up and emailing or phoning them. By making our own zone list in the form of Freelance, we can self-moderate and rebuild.
Can I join? Everyone is welcome. Contact Jill S. Creates for more information on how to join and secure a place. And then wiggle your cursor to move faster. Gearhead Greg. Alright. So, the person who is in charge of them that works at Gearhead, works at Merchantsoft, is Roddy? Right? Has to be. And this is the Freelance with Chowderman's ready to shave! This is the song that somebody linked me that got me to play this game. Overdrive. To my skin, riding along my flesh, I need confidence and patience. If any world, the galaxy of innocence. Dude, I want to just sit and listen to this song once. I know it's like 7 minutes long, though. If you want to listen to this song, look up Chowder Man Ready to Shave. I think we're just gonna keep playing. Welcome to Sci Freelance. Click on the arrow signs to move. Click on landmarks to visit members' pages. Click on or hover over signs to read them. Oh, you can just hover. Alright. Uh-oh. Did my internet just die? It looks like I'm still online. Alright. So this is Freelance 6E. Move south to visit Jill and Sarah's homestead. They have a lot of like double clicky things in this game. Like things where you click on one box and it's the same as clicking on another. Hail and well met. Welcome to the Sanders homestead. I'm gonna have to turn the music off, I'm sorry. Welcome to the Sanders homestead. Please wipe your shoes at the door. Jill's page and Sarah's page. Yep, this is Jill Sanders. Jill creates. You have just stepped into the warm abode of Jill and Sarah Sanders. On Jill's page, you'll find fantasy, sci-fi, and cybercog art of the Sanderverse and his HSM music. Oh, it's Gil! It's not Jill, it's Gil. It's a fucking guy. God, I thought it was Jill. It's Gil Sanders. Holy shit. Alright, let me take his ID. I'm gonna book him. Gil. Jesus Christ. I still don't know where to put the IDs, though. I'll need to, like, ask somebody. This is an anti-sacred garden home. We do not support the touchy-feely, wimpy direction their company is headed. We are the founders of the Sovereign Alliance of Imagination. If you want to join a welcoming group, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, and this is, like, takes you back here. Okay. Oh my god, Chowder Man, please. Alright, Jill's page. Note for all you smart Alex out there, the page is Gil S. S as in Sanders, my last name. It's not Gil Secretes. Huh? Oh, Gil S. Creates, not Gil Secretes. Thank you. With that out of the way, welcome. Oh, God. Ready to shave analysis page. A work in progress, full analysis of the music and lyrics of the epic masterpiece. But I'm reading this. I love this song. I really think, like, I listened to this song about 2 weeks ago. And I was like, I've got to know where this is from. And then I looked it up, and it was from Hypnospace, and I got gifted Hypnospace Outlaw by Grummeldunk in, like, December last year? Maybe it was my birthday, maybe it was only April this year, I don't know, I can't remember. But it was the kick I needed to play this. Forward by Gil. That's weird. What kind of music is that? Song about shaving? Get out of town.
If I had a penny for every time I heard one of these ignorant statements, I would have millions of dollars. Can you blame them? They're just ignorant and uninformed. There's no appreciation anymore of fine art. Everyone just wants it now. If you really take time to listen, I listened to this record at least 500 times. At least, you will begin to appreciate kinds of music you never thought possible. All you hear now on the radio is flip-flop, I wish it flopped, with lyrics about dirty acts, shooting gangs, or sniffing drugs. What happened to when real men made real music? The music one could put headphones on after school and get lost in. Music for the thinking man. Music where they actually play instruments instead of push buttons on a computer. Ready to shave song analysis part 1. Whiskers growing at the speed of light. Put the trimmer into overdrive. Thoughts are running through my mind. Just the bathroom and the night. Here we are transported to a tense scene in the Chowder Man's bathroom. This first verse is brilliant because it is both a story and a metaphor. A metaphor represents something else other than the obvious thing. His whiskers, a metaphorical representing of the things holding him back in life, are growing at the speed of light. He has to put the trimmer on overdrive to get rid of them. When you put something into overdrive, that means you are testing the limits of that thing. Let's take a car for example. If you overdrive a car, you are running that engine so hot that it could explode, but the advantage is that you go really fast and pass all the slower drivers. Back to the song though. He then switches to a more personal few lines where he lets us know that the thoughts are running through my mind and that he's lonely in a bathroom at night. This sets the moody stage for the rest of the song. I imagine he's in a bathroom at a truck stop, his hands trembling as he tries to frantically shave these whiskers, again, a metaphor of life.
You know, I actually feel like this guy's onto something. I feel like this is an actual thing, right? Because it's a deep song, right? It's a deep song about one man and his issues with, you know, his issues. He's not shaving in the morning to get ready to go anywhere. He's shaving at night. He's made a decision at night that he's unhappy with something and he's looking to change it. You know what I'm saying? He's looking to change his whiskers because they're growing at the speed of light. It's real. It's real deep. It's deep and it's real and it's real deep.
Spray the shaving cream into my hand. Lather up. The world don't understand. Man inside the mirror now. Should I finally let him out?
True.
Again, we have two lines that are the metaphor, represents another thing.
Exactly,
of shaving,
Ronald
and then two
Dunk.
Lines
exactly.
That are very personal. The line lather up, the world don't understand is very meaningful.
Lather up, the world don't understand.
Lets their whiskers grow. They just let all the evil
got
consume them until they are running the rat race like
shave.
All the others, bitter and consummated. The last two lines represent this hidden power that comes into play later in the song.
Yeah.
He knows that shaving will let it out, but is he really ready? Note, the Chowder Man often brings musical or lyrical themes back later. This is known as a leitmotif in music theory. It is very complex.
I like that this is kind of like written by the guy who knows about music, right? Like, you know, you don't just look up like what some weird things I can say about music. I like this. This is cool. This is some cool shit. The Chowder Man song is also fucking great. This is the song that somebody linked me. Remember how I said that I got linked a song by Chowder Man and it made me want to, you know, play the game? This is the song. Alright. So, that was the Ready to Shave analysis page. Let's go into Gil's Tunes. I really hate that it does this thing where you have like two things to click to go to the same place. It makes me think at some point one of them is going to take you somewhere else.
Downloading Gil Cybercogicus.
Circus? Cybercog Circus? I'm pretty new to making music. I'm not terrible, or so my wife says, but I'm still learning. So I'm really not really looking for feedback right now, since I know it's a little rough. Thank you. Alright, let's listen to Gil's song. Oh yeah, we got some dragons. Actually. We got some fucking dragons. I don't like that one. I don't like that one. This one's cool. Yeah.
Music file added to TuneBox library.
It wasn't that one. There we go. Gil's Cybercog Circus. This is literally clowncore. This is clowncore music. You have an old shitty tattoo that looks a bit like this dragon. You know what? Just because you said that, let's put it on Chowder Man's chest as like a chest tattoo. Oh no. The green one? I don't like the green one because it's the one that lactates. It's the one that lactates, right? They said that the green dragon milk comes from the green dragon, and it creeps me out. I don't like the green milk. Dude, what is our fucking desktop? What is this? Jesus Christ. Alright. Back to the internet. The Sandverse. Holy shit, look at these tits! Holy shit, look at this tit! Look at this ass! Jesus Christ. She looks like that girl from the Wild Thornberrys. Wild Thornberrys blonde daughter. Debbie. She looks like Debbie from the Wild Thornberrys. Jesus Christ. Can I download this Debbie? Or this cog guy? What the fuck is this? Is this a whole lore? Oh yeah, by the way, we found out about Chowder Man losing his leg in a helicopter accident. Got my leg and I'm ready to shave. Jesus Christ. I don't even know if I want to read this. Custom campaign for Quest of Six Mountains 4 role set. Sandverse is an original Quest of Six Mountains interactive theater campaign with its own world, characters, and lore. It combines traditional fantasy with the best parts of science fiction and cybercog. Is this Dungeons & Dragons? Our character is Serenia, is a character me and my wife Sarah made up. Based on many of Sarah's real-life quirks, Serenia is a master archer and can use telepathy to communicate with almost any being in Sandverse. This drawing is my own artistic interpretation of Serenia. Click the link below to see my wife's drawing that she uses in-game. It's gonna be totally fucking hell! Oh, yeah, Freezer had a riot. There was a riot on Freezer's... during Freezer's, like, stage show, right? Holy shit. This looks like the Pictish Man. You know that, like, chalk drawing from in England on the side of the mountain made out of chalk? Jesus Christ. Holy shit. Telepathic abilities. Oh no.
Serenia is the character I play in my husband and mice interactive.
This fucking picture.
She is an archer with mind reading and telepathic communication abilities. Though she's an excellent archer, she only attacks when absolutely necessary. She feels a strong sense of compassion and empathy for others due to her telepathic
abilities. The wife
abilities.
Just made her, like,
so
tall
her
and
employing diplomacy is always how she tries to resolve things.
The wife just made her tall and made her have all the equipment she needs. And the husband just fucking drew a big fucking walloping pair of tits. And a huge fucking dump truck ass.
Gilnull is played by me, Gil. He plays a guitar that is used to hack into CyberCog systems when plugged into them. The notes are interpreted as computer inputs. Signal Null was once a rock star, based a little on Chowder Man.
So true, he likes what he likes, fuck it, right? Getting into trouble with Sarah. I like the glittery metal boots and,
you
know.
He must always wear sunglasses because his unshielded gaze is too powerful.
His unshielded gaze.
Ginsby. Ginsby is a cybernome character played by our friend Stooge. His character is always trying to cause mischief and crack jokes, which is honestly a little annoying
this
and interrupts
cute.
The game. I'll scan in artwork when I get around to it.
This is cute, I like this. Weapons and items, the cluster blade. Ooh, baby.
The X010001 cluster blade is the most powerful weapon in all of the Sandiverse. It is the object that all characters and factions are trying to find.
No. It's been literally like over 4 months since we played D&D. Like, it's completely over. There's no way the D&D is ever starting back up. Turtle joined, and I think we did 2 weeks with Turtle, and then the third week got delayed. Like, the third session that was going to be, like, Turtle's third session got delayed by, like, I think it was, like, 5 or 6 weeks. And then it's never started back up, so I think it's just gone. It happens to, like, most campaigns. They just, like, fizzle out because of scheduling. But, yeah.
If you're familiar with CyberCog Classic Syrixia, data cogs work pretty much the same way as they do in the book. Their contents can be decrypted and absorbed into the mind at cogwork terminals, and they can grant people abilities far beyond what humans are normally capable of.
It'd be cool to start D&D again, but, yeah.
Cogwork terminals are rare machines that are used by humanoids in the Sandiverse to absorb data cog data into their mind. They often go haywire, causing unintended side effects. Once absorbed, this data grants special knowledge, superhuman skills, and sometimes powerful techno-psychic abilities.
So these are like skill points.
Cogwork terminals are old, unreliable,
right?
And only a few remain.
Yeah.
Couches look like normal sofas and couches, but they
actually crave
flesh.
It's a mimic couch.
They are common in the Sandiverse since most of the world consists of old high-rises and dusty abandoned apartments, connected to one another by metal walkways.
Nice. Mammogroth.
The Mammogroth, once thought of as an urban myth, is the result of a human attempting to absorb the fabled 0Z1X data cog. The Mammogroth lives in the northern viney groves and is highly territorial. The Mammogroth only speaks in grunts, but has been known to communicate telepathically and is believed to be highly intelligent. Vilarthan is the ruler of the largest post-Earth settlement, the Towers. He wields absolute power and is quick to dispatch of beings who stand in the way of his kingdom's expansion plans. He wields the Scepter of Leafwind, an ancient cybercogian tool that gives its master control over all plant life.
What use is a fucking plant life scepter in a place that's high-rise metal towers connected through bridges and walkways? What fucking plant are you going to control? Moss?
Copyright Gil Sanders. If you would like to play your own Sanderverse game, chit-chat me and I will send my
campaign
book.
Fun fact, if you put a TM logo, or you say trademark, and then you put like the date after anything you create, and this is 100% true, you can look this up, not copyright, but trademark. If you trademark something like that, and you don't pay for the trademark, it is still trademarked. What you do is, say for example, I came up with Fartiverse, right? Fartiverse is like a new D&D game. And I publish the rules online, and I write at the bottom, trademark Depresso, right? 2022. You can then use that trademark Depresso 2022 as proof of when you established it and intended to trademark it. It shows intention to trademark, and intention to trademark can be used to fight against somebody who tries to trademark something that you've previously come up with. It's an actual thing. You actually have a lot more rights of stuff like you publish and create than most people think. Like, for example, if you draw a picture and put it online, I'll use DeviantArt because DeviantArt is like a specific thing for this. If you put it on DeviantArt, you have a Creative Commons license and you get all the things afforded to you by the Creative Commons license. So people can't use your design for profit. People can't like copy your design and steal it. You're actually really legally protected. But if you had something that's like more abstract, like a D&D campaign or something like that, you could put trademark. You can trademark like a rule set for a video game or a comic book or a title for a story or something. You can do that shit. It's totally a thing. It shows intent to trademark. So you're totally like, it's, I always used to think it was silly when people put like a trademark logo next to their stuff, but it's fucking real. Like, it's an actual thing. If somebody was to like publish something similar to what you've done with the same name, you could be like, actually, you know, I used this name for 5 years and I wrote trademark next to it because I intended to trademark it, but never did. It's a thing. Anyway, enough trademark laws with Depp. Welcome to the virtual hypnospace study of Sarah Sanders. I'm a 41-year-old wife and big-time daydreamer. This is my place, so it's my way or the highway. Enjoy your stay. Sarah Sanders Art Gallery. Oh, you just click it and it like scrolls up and down. Okay. Cactus with an arrow. Oh, wait.
If you hang out around the Psy a lot, you've probably seen Gil's art. He made all of the map graphics for the freelance.
Oh!
I dabble too. Though my stuff isn't as good as Gil's, I do have fun making it.
This is cute. Cyrix is the race that her her D&D character is. I read that in the thing. Buttercup the horse, Serenia, my character in the Sandverse. Deborah the giant gnome. Deborah's, why would you have a giant gnome? Why wouldn't you just be like a, isn't a giant gnome just like a normal person? What is a giant gnome? It's just a, it's like a gnome but big. I mean, what? Oh god, Deborah the giant gnome. Deborah's a character wrote for the Sandverse. Gil thinks she's too stupid, so he won't include her. I feel like it is very stupid. I like her very progressive hairy legs, though, you know, and her four fingers. Sarah's quick opinions. Movie The Blender.
Movie review, The Blender. Linda Horror suggested this and wow, is it cheesy. I wonder if I'm missing something because the gory parts are amusing when they are on, but most of it is just bad dialogue between amateur actors. 5/10.
5/10, that's a perfect, almost a perfect score. If that was 5/7, that'd be a perfect score. You like the giant gnome? She's like 80% torso as well. I'm not really sure. I feel like whoever drew these, I don't think that the creators of the game drew these. I think they got somebody that can't draw to draw these, rather than attempting to draw them bad themselves. And I'm basing that on how the hand is doing this thing. Beginner artists like to do this thing where they show every finger, right? And every picture that this person's drawn is showing every finger regardless, right? Regardless of pose. They also like to stick the feet going out to the side. This is a very beginner thing. Like, these are things that people like to do. I can't remember what you call it. There's a word for it. There's a word for it. It's not symbol drawing, but it's something similar. You always go for a gnome barbarian. I don't even know. I'm random whenever I play games, right? I feel like we do some different builds. The only thing I always try is always try the shotguns first. Because shotguns are like
music review,
either
awesome,
terrible or
fragments.
Great, and you've got to find
this
out.
This is an album Stooge puts on while we're gaming. I need him to record me a copy because sometimes I get lost in the atmosphere of the music and forget about our game. 10/10.
Okay, Arcello Fragments. We should try and get that at some point. Oh, she has a different Hypnoverse thing. You know? She has a different headband than her husband, so I guess they can both use it at the same time. Yeah, his ID is 25A and hers is 27A. Yeah, I don't know, when it's like fantasy games, what do I even do? I end up like, when I play Skyrim, I end up as a stealth archer,
travel
but so does everybody
Orlando,
else, right?
Florida. Orlando is only fun if you're rich. We stayed in a happy birthday hotel there and it was adequate, but the theme parks were so disappointing. Most of your time there will involve waiting in long lines while the sun fries
nice.
Your skin. 2/10.
Fuck Florida. I'm kidding. Florida's great. Yeah, that's it. That's it for these guys, I guess. So that's their little castle. Who the hell's page is this? Casper Air Graphics LLC, legal liable company. Automotive airbrushing and art by Casper Sandberg. I'm copying his ID. He seems like a guy that would steal music. What is this? Clifton? Alright, let's look at some of his art. The gallery. this is the type of van that you tell your kids to avoid. You know what I'm saying? Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. This is actually okay. I like this. This does seem like the type of van that will smell like weed, right? Just imagine the window rolled down a bit and like smoke coming out. Jesus Christ. About Casper.
Casper has always been an artist, but 10 years ago he found his true calling when a musical collaborator opened his eyes to the world of airbrush art. After working as a successful musician and composer for almost 30 years, Casper took up airbrush art in 1989 and hasn't looked back. Casper specializes in fantasy and science fiction art, but he's always open to new concepts.
Alright, music. Oh no, he's a Trennis fan. He likes Trennis.
I was the lead guitarist and composer for the band Clifter from 1970 until
1988. What the fuck?
We were famous for our long cosmic rock jams and deep fantasy mythology. Unfortunately, I do not own the rights to Clifter's music anymore, so I can't provide it for download, but a song from my best album is playing on my page. If you are familiar with the FLIST system, you can find some of the songs there. I personally don't mind if you download it that way. Trennis fans might recognize my song Sport Anthem as the official theme of the Trennis North American Open. I'm learning how to record music on the computer and hope to release a record under my name sometime.
No violation! He's encouraging piracy. He's telling people to go and download the music on FLIST.
I was the lead guitarist and composer for the band Clifter from 1970 until 1988.
All right, we've heard it. Music. Quote. Quote for Airbrush Art. Please send Casper a message through ChitChat or HS inbox for Casper Air Graphics to inquire about the cost of an airbrush treatment for your vehicle or any other kind of fantasy art you need. Casper does not take explicit, gory, or pornographic requests. Please do not message Casper about Clifta. Oh, some bad blood? Go check out Ringleader Roddy and House of Sound. They both have great Hypnospace pages. Also, I'm open for work and can turn your car into a work of art. Oh, fuck. Clicked the wrong thing. I'm a little bit confused by one thing. Why don't Gil and Sarah have a van that's being customized? You know? They seem like custom van people. Is that the fucking Seattle fucking tower? What the fuck is this? What the shit is this? New game reviews every week or so. Oh, this song's dank! Oh! This song's fucking sick! You can't see it right now, but I'm bobbing my head. Alright, enough of that. We'll see if we can download this later. What's this guy's page? Oscar Sparrow. I'm writing down his code. Somebody needs to tell me how to use Flist, though. Grummeldunk, can you tell me how to use Flist? Alright. I got onto Flist. And I got a password. Right, so I'm on Flist, but I don't know what to do. I don't know how do I get onto people's pages, right? How to find Flist file directories. New users, you're able to see Flist directories by searching for Flist IDs. So do I literally just, like, because I've logged in, do I just type in people's IDs now and I just get on it? You just add it in the URL? So 025 02A. No. This is Randy's ID. Oh. Hey. He's selling Taurus.
Downloading Accelerator. Downloading Taurus_whip_2. Downloading Taurus_whip_2B.
That's really
downloading
easy.
Downloading Taurus_whip_2B. Final. Downloading 3Y3. Downloading Taurusks.
Let's have a look at what we just got. Ah, it's a sandwich encrypted file. I don't even know what I'm doing. Oh, he's stealing. Oh, wait. No, we already had that, didn't we? Didn't we already have that Taurus wallpaper? I think we already had that Taurus wallpaper. I think we got that from somewhere else. I like this one with the cock. No way. Oh, it's like his work in processes. Ah, this is like his sketch version. I know that feel.
Music file added to Tunebox library.
Accelerator has been installed. fuck is this? Does this make everything run faster? What the fuck is this shit? Download and loading speed booster for Hypno OS. Click the accelerator, it's completely free to download.
Downloading accelerator.
Oh no, I'm downloading more of it. Accelerator.
One.
Donate to one or all of these great people. Fidrel is one of a kind artist. Casper is an amazing artist who makes vans and trucks into priceless works of art. Oh my. Oh, who owns this page? Roddy! Fucking Roddy. Jesus Christ. No wonder we found the accelerator download on his first page. Alright. Let's look for some more. Oh! Jill creates.
Downloading awesome Ivid. Downloading Chowder Coolfest.
What? Chowder Coolfest wall? No way! No way. No way. No fucking way, dude. I'm just gonna leave this running, by the way. It's the whole time. You can't pin it, though. So if I open this and then close it... Alright, it still runs. Bought all the Shouter Man stuff yet? I don't think it was all available for purchase yet, until, like, recently. What do you think awesome vid is? No way! I'm the Chowder Man, king of the pipe. Bouncing on the boy's dick every night. It's not about food. Type in a comment. Click. You gotta be the strongest and fight to succeed. I'm climbing the mountains. I'm swimming the rivers. I'm the eagle in the sky. And I'm ready for dinner. Life's a highway. And I'm the car. If you ride with Chowder Man, you're gonna go far. Was that boobs? What the fuck? The fucking flag! All high five the world. Let the chowder be heard. I like to eat right. I choose healthy snacks. The Chowder Man even writes his own raps. I always party hard. I'm the best in the biz. I'm the party prophet. That's just the way it is. I don't buy a round of drinks. I buy a square. When I smoke cigars, I only smoke them in pairs. Inspiring things are really, really, really great. No, the flag. It was raising the flag on Iwo Jima. It was the fucking Iwo Jima flag raise from, Hobbies, a garden and paint. Oh, no. My message, fighting the greed. I suspect the Chowder Man is all you need. I love to gamble and I love to dance. This chowder lifestyle, hey, give it a chance. I'm the chowder future and the chowder past. And if you mess with me, I'll kick your chowder ass. I think it is meant to be like Child of Man. You know how we talked about this and I said I wasn't going to let it go? He just said I'm the chowder future and I'm the chowder past. I think he's trying to say I'm the child of future and I'm the child of past. I think it's chowder is meant to be like child of. I think that's where it comes from. I wanna email them and find out. Look at the dance. That's how I dance. I'm not even kidding. That's how I dance. Apart from this move, I don't do this move. The like fucking Crypt Keeper. This is how I dance. The only other Hot Dad song I know is Hot Dad, Internet Comment Etiquette, this one. I know this song.
I'm Big Money Salvia, king of the pipe. Typing out comments all damn night.
I know that song. That's like the only... That's the only Big Hot Dad song I know. I'm the fucking bomber behind them. I'm the Charo B. I'm the Charo B. What the fuck is this? I'm the Charo B. I'll look up for that later. I will. I'll look it up tonight. I really think it's meant to be Child of Man. Complete side note, if you wanted to watch a video on your Nintendo DS, you had to transfer the file into being called a .ogg or a .3ps or something. What was the name of the file? You converted it to like this shitty file, and there was a little program you could do that you could put like MP4s into it or WAVs, and it would convert it into the file for you, and it would make them tiny, because a Nintendo DS, original DS. The file format was like 124 by 160 pixels, and it literally looked like this. It had the color range of like a fucking, oh, just the shortest color range, like 4 greens, 5 reds. Why does he look so different than he does in the Big Money Salvia video? Like, he really looks like a different person when he puts the glasses on in the hat. Fuck, that was so good. That was actually so good. That was so worthwhile. No way!
Downloading Cinder's Poetry Journal.
Poetry Journal? Dude, it's like I found the deep web. Is this our first text file? How do I... Oh, these poems express my lack of ideas. A selection of my writings from over the years.
A selection of my writings from over the years. Most of this ceased once I exited college, but I look back fondly on these. Untitled sonnet. My fingers are broken. My memories forgot. Not once have I spoken. My lungs full of rot. Who was
what
I in
the
life?
Fuck?
And where did it end? A family, a wife. Money to spend. I do not know. Nor may I ever. I creep now, slow. Though my brain they did sever. A mindless shell. Bound to earth like hell. Untitled Free Verse 01. It's humorous, how freedom can be so hindering. Given one simple guideline, I can't think of a thing. Be careful what you wish for. This is sound advice. Free will is as crippling. As the stab of a knife. Untitled Free Verse 02. These poems express my lack of ideas.
Dude, this is like honestly finding the keys to the candy shop. I'm gonna have so much fun looking up people's fucking IDs. You're using Accelerator. Please consider donating HypnoCoin to the member. Oh, yeah. I don't think she likes Gil. I think Gil's a little bit sexist, right? A little bit.
Downloading Casper Artwall. Downloading Clifter Rotortaps 01. Downloading Clifter Rotortaps 02. Downloading Clifter Rotortaps 04.
Can I hit these up for content infringement? No violation? This whole page is a violation.
Music file added to Tunebox library.
Fucking Clifter. No. I haven't went around the whole map yet. You mean like the map area? What the fuck is this? Jesus Christ, why is my fucking desktop so cancerous right now? Look at this shit! Look at this fucking desktop! Oh my god, it's fucked! It's fucked! Oh my god, it's literally like... It's like when your old neighbor is like, "Hey, Sonny, come and look at my computer, it's acting up!" And you go over and it's just like, this computer needs to be put down. Like, the most humane thing would be to just put this computer down, right? Like, just unplug it and just never speak of it again. Like, by this computer being attached to the HypnoWeb, I feel like I'm infecting other people's computers just by, like, proximity. I really don't think this is a good idea. Oh no. It's so bad. It's so bad. I can't. Oh no. 11217A. Alright. So Oscar doesn't have a FLST. Whew. Holy shit. I forgot how to get to the freelance. Fuck off, accelerator pop-ups. Yeah, you gotta have everything to make it run faster, right? Oh yeah, we're on this guy's page first. Squishers review. Holy shit! It's literally Pokemon! Kinda looks a bit like Mega Man as well.
A unique slime fist earned the game champ's first decent title. Note, forgive the blurry screenshots, it is hard to take pictures of the Game Champ Portable's tiny screen. Squishers are everywhere. TV, radio, and the internet, and even Hypnospace. If you aren't seeing ads for it, you're hearing tales of concerned parents and addicted children. It's easy to be cynical and write off massively popular titles as the inventions of toy-selling marketing XX. Squishers may be that, but as much as it pains me to say it, it's also an excellent game. Squishers has a simple, albeit odd, premise: a spaceship containing high-tech capsules full of gooey alien life was shot down over Earth. It crash-landed on an island.
He gave this a 92 out of 100.
Some capsules opened, releasing the slimy Squishers creatures contained inside. It's your job to rescue all 48 creature types that escaped, returning them to their capsules. So long as your Squishers of a similar species to your target creature, and the target is not considered your predator, you may have your Squishers engage in conversation with them.
Oh wow.
The more the creature engages in conversation, more persuasive they get.
So it's a bit like Undertale. Right? And this guy doesn't have a FLIST. He doesn't have a FLIST download. Alright, that's pretty cool. Why no Hypnospace OS games? This could be interesting.
Update, the 20th of November, 1999. Yes, I'm aware of drug runners in Teentopia. Why is an anti-drug game called Drug Runners? People who smuggle drugs are called drug runners. I'm truly baffled. It's a decent little game but is a mere trifle compared to Cyberworld's games.
I said the same thing.
Let's take stock of what we know. We know that the Hypnospace headband packs a surprising amount of power for a $500
computer. What the fuck? It's $500 for a Hypnospace headband?
We know that at least a few of the guys...
How is it $500 for a Hypnospace headband?
We know that merchants soft love money, as evidenced by their
pandering. That's fucking crazy.
The lowest common denominator in their marketing and advertising. We know that games make a lot of money.
That is fucking crazy. How is it $500 for a Hypnospace headband? That is fucking
so where
insane.
Are the games? To be fair, this isn't only merchant soft's problem. Cyberworlds, Hypnospace's fiercest sleep time competitor, is also bereft of games.
Oh!
I can't be alone in thinking that the first sleep time service to capitalize on the hungry horde of gamers is going to completely wipe out the competition. I will give a small amount of credit to Hypnospace for their virtual pets, but those things seem more toyline. I'm talking a full game experience here. So I guess that's it. Dylan, Adrian, where are the games? I've been saying this for years. Unfortunately,
so this is Dylan talking to
get the ball rolling on
to this guy
like
in Chichamp.
That said, I can't spill the beans, but do look forward to the Hypnos Year 2000 update.
Oh.
I think you will be pleased.
Is that the game that Winky's we were testing money. That blew up our fucking headset, though? Snub the nub. Counselor Ronnie. So, the T-Nub thing is complete bullshit, right? Like, it's not even real. The T-Nub thing is, like, complete dog shit. It's made up, and it means nothing. Speedy boots, teleportation charm, open lockers to find magic items. Are we playing this? Should we play this now? Oh my god, why is my throat so bad today? Tomorrow, I think I'm gonna have, like, a deep clean of my room. I'm literally gonna, like, purify the fucking earth here. I'm gonna, like, napalm my entire room. I have a feeling, like, it's just really dusty.
Downloading Drugrun setup.
Should we try this? What if Drugrun doesn't... What if it crashes our headset? Is this Counselor Runny ready for duty? Is this it? That was just an intro video? I thought that was gonna be like the play screen. T-nub. Dude, I got fucking shonked by a T-nub right in my booty hole.
Whoa, I've been shocked.
Oh no. Oh no. There's no way. This game fucking sucks. This game really sucks. I keep getting shonked.
Use the boots to run two spaces instead of one per turn.
Oh!
You lose.
Oh, dude, I got fucking shonked.
I've been shocked.
Is this worthwhile beating this game? No idea. I kind of feel like there's a chance this could be worth beating. This is just the first screen. This is just the first area. The boots are gonna help a lot though, right? Because now we can move two spaces. Oh shit, what do I do here?
Use the teleportation charm to teleport back to the main entrance of any room.
Oh! Cool. Ah, so if I move like this and then teleport, then move down and use the boots, I can go down like this. Oh, dude, I'm getting shonked in the T-nub. I don't know how you're meant to do anything. How are you meant to do that room? Counselor Rani, reporting for duty. Shocked in the T-nub. The last thing you want on your sandwich is Burger King foot lettuce. Fucking T-nub stuck up my anus. What is going on in this game? So if I bring them down here. Oh, it's hard to actually tell which one's the one that's moving. Okay. Charm to go back, and then left, down two, take off the boots, go down one, back up one, right one, down two. I think this is it. I think this is the final level. Because there's no more entrances out of this way in every other entrance we've seen. So take off the boots and go forward one and up one. Okay, boots to go to here. Whose voice is it saying, oh, I've been chonked? Do you think it's Big Dad? Probably is. Alright, if I charm my way back, then go right again, and then boots for two. Oh, I thought he was gonna go left. Does this guy not go left? It's hard to tell which one is which. Alright. I moved two instead of one. If I go down two, this guy gets me. What if I go down one? And then right? Shonked! Alright, we gotta get this. This is the final level. Whatever's in there is like the winning thing. Right? It's like the end prize. Probably picture a Counselor Ronnie's wife or something, I don't know. Right? down, right, left, charm, right, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, up. I think what I want is this, and then charm. And then this guy's gonna come down, so I can't move two spaces. But if I move one space, and then up, then right, then I can boot two spaces this way. It's this guy. This guy's fucking me. What if I charm here, and then I boot two spaces in, then go down? No, that doesn't help. I'm back to where I was. Yeah, chonked.
I've been sucked.
I might need a guide. I might need a drug runner's guide.
No, I've been sucked.
Counselor Ronnie. Oh, shit. When I'm here, and this guy's gonna go up, I can two over here, and then this guy's in front of me. The idea is to get myself in this square or this square, where I have a clear path, and I can two down. That's the idea. The idea is to get myself to one of these two squares, and then use the boots to go two down through this guy. Yeah. That's the whole thing. Because now if I go down two, I'm fucked.
No! I've been sucked!
Got chomped by the T-nubs! Shit, I clicked reset instead of charm. That was my bad. Looking it up. Drug runners walkthrough guide. Hypnospace. Oh no, this video is 18 minutes long. How is it 18 minutes long? Yeah, this is just a Hypnospace walkthrough guide. I need to do this on my own. It has to be possible.
No,
is it as simple as taking off the boots, going right, charming, and then right again? This guy's gonna go down, right? He's not gonna go up. Yeah, he goes down. So right, back. Yeah. It has to be... It has to be charm here, and then boots. And then down one, charm again. No, I'm not seeing this at all. It reminds me of that ice cube puzzle. Remember the fucking ice cube puzzle? The ice cube puzzle was horrific. In, what's it called? Zero escape. So this is like a little safe zone, right?
No,
oh, what the fuck? I pressed left instead of up and down.
No,
what?
I've been sucked.
Oh How? Oh, that guy goes down when there's somebody behind him. Okay. Which way is this guy going? Is he going left or right? That's it. That's it.
A healthy life. Downloading drug dealer. Drug yeah. Counselor and is helping our next
the fastest drug runner of them all. Yeah.
We did it. It downloaded something though. Counselor Ronnie Snub the Nub Extended.
Music file added to Tunebox Library.
Counselor Ronnie reporting for duty. For duty. Duty. Drugs make you pretty lame. Duty. Duty.
Well, duty. That was the price. I can't believe that was the fucking price.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Counselor Ronnie reporting for duty. For duty.
Does Ronnie have a page?
You can't take them. Yeah. If you're a cool teen, don't insert a bean. If you're a cool teen,
don't insert a bean. The extended version.
Nice one, man. Yeah. Stay safe out there.
Is that it?
Fingers, dude. I had a buddy named Vinny. He could stuff an entire pizza in his mouth. All without drugs.
What? I had a friend named Vinny, he could stuff an entire pizza in his mouth all without drugs. What in the actual fuck? Jesus Christ. Alright, this is Counselor Ronnie's FLST page.
Downloading teen up sticker. Downloading Y2000 challenge.
All you're going to find here is a random nonsense from M1N1.
All you're going to find here is random nonsense from M1NX. Also this really bad wallpaper that I should probably just delete. Downloading Taurus Gnomon.
Are you protected? Pro Medical Solutions, 223 years old, 0656D. That's literally Counselor Ronnie's... Wait! Counselor Ronnie is actually Pro Medical Solutions? Oh my lord. Is he the one selling the T-Nubs? Is he the supplier? Alright, let's have a look at these things. T-Nub sticker. That is 100% meant to be tampons. Oh god. Can you survive the 48 hours year 2000 sleep time challenge? Win 100 grand from Merchant Brothers. Over 18 only, M1NX. Who the fuck is M1NX? Terry Snowman. Oh god, I want to see this wallpaper. Oh my. This is good. This is good art. Holy shit. You know what I want to do? I want to watch other people who have played this game and just see what their desktops look like at the end. Because mine is literally, every time I look at this, it makes me laugh. It's so fucking bad. It's so bad. Oh no. So Counselor Ronnie is actually Pro Medical Solutions.
Counselor Ronnie.
He's not Ronnie Porter. Or he could be both. Very weird. Alright, back to the thing. What did you say? You said something, right? Did you explore all of Dream Station? There is a kind of hidden location which has a very Gil moment. Haven't found that yet. Haven't found it. But we also haven't visited everywhere. I think we went right. And that's Gil's house. Right, we did all this. And then I guess there was nothing else here. Maybe up, and then something's here. The Trial of Acceleration.
Downloading Axe's Trial 1.
This is another fucking accelerating thing? Holy shit. We already have like a million copies. I really need to find a sandwich encryption thing to get into that stuff. Do you have what it takes to complete the acceleration trial and wield the almighty power of acceleration? First you must find the secret path. You're right, there is a secret path. The bull ring. Oh wait.
Downloading Axe's Trial 1.
A secret stash is hidden in the Freelands.
Is this it? Is it like a scavenger hunt? Alright, we need to write this down. Trial of Acceleration.
Now unlock it. Two east of Roddy's bullring, that's me. One north of Casper's rocket. Only one path leads to this place. Look closely at the borders. Once you find it, come back here. In this trial, you will rock it.
Alright. Two east of Roddy's bullring, one north of Casper's rocket. This is it. Click here to open the stash of acceleration, only if worthy.
Downloading Axe's Trial 2. Axe's Trial 2. 1.
Ooh, this is it. This is another like note though, maybe. Maybe I need another note for this.
The father of the Freelands, his Cybercogian name. The mother of the Freelands, what she shoots in her game. The amount of zones that Merchantsoft sent to an early grave. Now return to the Freelands, south of the Colosseum, and input this code you figured out for your final test. I really hope to see ya.
Really hope to see ya. So, it's Bo and it's 5, right? What is this? Court of Phaedrella? Oh, this is where her thing is. Alright. Yeah, we've already seen her site, but we've got to it from a different way. Rip gamers only. So this is where you would see what they've put in the bin. This is the five places. Yeah, and we've seen Linda's Library of the Weird. We've already done that. Alright. So hold on. What was his name? Signal. So the password is Signal. Is it null with 1L or 2? And then Bo 5, or it could be Signal Arrow 5. I don't really know what she shoots. I mean, she shoots a bow and arrow, but I guess she shoots arrows and bows. And then it said to go one below the court, right? enter the password. So it's sig null arrow 5. You are worthy of acceleration. Accelerator is only for members of the Sovereign Alliance of Imagination. To prove that you're a member of the Sovereign Alliance of Imagination and gain access to Accelerator, please answer the following 6 questions. What is the name of Psy's special custom-made zone? It's the Freelance. What did Casper Air Graphics do before he made... guitar in Cosmic Rock Band. What are short scary stories involving... They're called, spookies. Right? Scaries! Which popular dragon adoptee is an impish prankster and goofball? This dragon was famous in Dream Castle? I can't remember which one it was. Shit. Was it Gradalus? Sorry, pal. Can I just go back and pick another answer? The Freelance, Cosmic Rock, Scaries, Snoggleloff. Oh god, I can just keep doing this, right? What the fuck? How am I getting this wrong all this time? Alright, it was the 5th one. What are Taurus and Muleta, aside from being the coolest comic book heroes in the world? A humanoid bull in a sentient cape, a human bullfighter, a psychic bull in a magic carpet, a mutant ox and a red flying squirrel. Codenames for 2 human secret agents. This, right? What highly valuable cybercog item grants superpowers after decrypted? It's a data cogs. Congratulations, you are worthy. Are you fucking kidding? That was my prize? My prize was just this page that I found earlier. My prize was this page that I found like fucking 10 years ago. I found this an hour ago. Okay. Oh my god. Oh my god. I can't even. Can I ban these guys for malicious software? There we go, get fucked. Get absolutely fucked. Also, isn't this extra legal commerce? Because you're not allowed to transfer coins to each other. Donation buttons for transferring coins is actually really not allowed. Message received from dispatch. Okay. I got a message from dispatch. Ooh, this is Hello, Depresso. This is a content infringement notice regarding multiple instances of unauthorized music distribution reported in unknown zone. Please utilize your enforcement tool to report and remove them as soon as possible. Hello, Depresso. I've noticed we had a ton of backed up music piracy reports from the last few weeks that are never assigned to an enforcer. That were never assigned to an enforcer. I've attached the report's text files. Please do these ASAP. It sounds very serious. Good luck and thanks. This case has been manually assigned to Depresso by Miss Samantha. Click the cases tab above to view your progress on this case.
Downloading report underscore 11-13-1999. Downloading report underscore 11-12-1999. Downloading report underscore 10-19-1999.
Okay. Okay, we got a case. Very cool. I wonder if, like, proccing, or banning, like, one thing freelance, like, kind of just one thing that looked like it broke the law, is what caused me to get the, new report. I guess we read these in... Oh. Yeah, this one's first, right? Because Americans do months, year. Yeah, yeah. There's not a 13th month in the year or a 19th month. Okay. Your Hypnospace service... Wait. Meet Goat Records, processed by Hypnospace Intern 005. Your Hypnospace service has been used to access, download, or distribute our copyright works without authorization. Artist Glamocaster, Glamoplasm. Okay. There's a download of a song, Sport Anthem, by the band Clifta. The copyright is held by a company called QPL. Okay, okay. Can we drag these? I'll put them on my tree. Alright. Anyway. It is 11. I think I'm going to end the stream. We did a lot of enforcing. We did a lot of Hypnospace enforcing. And look, we even got this beautiful Roddy artwork of Taurus and Cape Man. Our desktop is looking fantastic right now. I don't know if we're playing this tomorrow. Tomorrow's the 16th, right? 16th, 17th, and then the 18th. So, I guess we only have two more days before the Ascent DLC comes out. So maybe tomorrow... Yeah, maybe I'll try and get through a little bit more of this tomorrow and the day after. I'm pretty set on playing the Ascent DLC. And then it's a couple of days after that that the new Saints Row comes out. The new Saints Row is huge. Like, it's like a 40-hour game. So it's definitely going to take up pretty much every moment. Yeah. Alright, auf Wiedersehen. Good night. I guess we'll play this tomorrow. I guess we will. We'll try and finish. We'll try and actually do the missions and not just like look around like we've been doing. Because the missions seem to take you to the most interesting stuff and the rest of it seems like extra, you know, extra stuff. If that makes any sense. Small donation of HypnoCoin. That's what I mean. Like, I think like this is extra legal. You're not meant to transfer HypnoCoin. It says it on the thing. All right. Good night. Good night.